fifth graders, I'm Trent. In the fifth grade, you need to learn math concepts for many reasons. Concepts are big ideas. Understanding the big ideas will help you do well on the AIMS test, get better grades in math, and prepare you for math classes in the future.
Plus, it is fun to solve problems and use parts of your brain you have never used before. When I solve a challenging math problem, it makes me feel great. I know the more I learn now, the brighter my future is. My name is Alexis. Let's get on with the show. We hope you enjoy
What's the Big Idea?
The big idea of this video is quadrilaterals. Quadrilaterals are four-sided polygons. There are famous quadrilaterals that we see every day in the real world, like rectangles.
The floors in most rooms are rectangular. A soccer field, football field, and volleyball court are all rectangles.
There are other types of quadrilaterals like squares, rhombuses, and trapezoids. However, in this show, we will focus on rectangles and parallelograms.
We will also discuss the terms parallel, perpendicular, and congruent.
Let's bring in Jonah, our intelligent and insightful math vocabulary person. Jonah will tell us about some words relating to quadrilaterals.
Thank you, Trent. Of course, the prefix quad means four, so quadrilateral is a four-sided polygon. Parallel is the property where two lines or line segments are on the same plane, but never intersect. Perpendicular describes two lines or line segments that form a 90-degree or right angle. Congruent means same measurement. Congruent sides are the same length. Let's look at two types of quadrilaterals, rectangles and parallelograms. Rectangles have two pair of parallel sides. The opposite sides are congruent. The sides that form angles are perpendicular. They form right angles. Parallelograms also have two pairs of parallel sides that are congruent, but the interior angles do not have to be right angles. Trent and Alexis will discuss examples of quadrilaterals. Have fun.
Thanks, Jonah. What did the acorn say when he grew up? Gee, I'm a tree. Get it? Geometry. The study of quadrilaterals is part of geometry.
I love geometry, the study of shapes. Were you paying attention to Jonah? Did you already know the terms parallel, perpendicular, and congruent?
In Mesa, Arizona, most of our roads run north and south or east and west. So most of our roads are either parallel or perpendicular. Broadway and Main Street are parallel. Broadway and Gilbert Road are perpendicular.
What type of quadrilateral is formed by the streets Power, Brown, Rucker, and University, as seen in this illustration? Please tell your classmate in a quiet voice.
A rectangle. Can you see the parallel and perpendicular sides? Now take turns telling a partner the streets that are parallel and the streets that are perpendicular.
Most intersections in Mesa connect two perpendicular streets. The next time you are in your family car waiting at a red light, think about the two perpendicular streets.
A parallelogram is often like a rectangle being blown to one side by the wind. The opposite sides are congruent, but the sides that form the angles may not be perpendicular.
Let me tell you two facts and see if you understand. All rectangles are parallelograms. Some parallelograms are rectangles.
I get it. A rectangle has all the properties of a parallelogram. However, some parallelograms, like this one, do not have perpendicular sides, so they are not rectangles.
Quadrilaterals rock. Look, my arms are perpendicular.
Mine are parallel. Thank you for watching this video. What's the big idea? Quadrilaterals.
Learning fifth grade math, big ideas, is awesome. We appreciate your attention and hope you like this video.
Math rocks. For Trent and MVP Jonah, I'm Alexis. See you next time on
What's the Big Idea?